Hey, this is Dennis. It's Saturday. I came down with sick with something really bad Monday, and I've been fighting it ever since. I feel like I'm pulling out of it now, but my wife, she got sick with it 2 or 3 days ago, so I don't know what it is, but that old orange tree right there is loaded with oranges, and I've been juicing that, and then also with this lemon tree here, taking the lemons and the oranges and juicing it, and then taking the peels and chopping it up and boiling it and simmering it and straining it. And that's what we've been using for medicine, and it's working. It's slowly pulling us out. I hope all y'all are doing good, but I just been making myself go today, and one of the things, I just want to get back in the Word just for a short period of time and get back in the groove here. I want to take up where we left off. We're in the book of Matthew. We're going to take up in chapter 16. Verse 13. And when Jesus came into the coasts of Caesarea Philippi, he asked the disciples, saying, "Who do men say that I, the Son of Man, am?" So Jesus asked his disciples there, he said, "Who do people say that I am?" And they said, "Some say that thou art John the Baptist, some Elias, same as Elijah, others Jeremias, or one of the prophets." Then he said unto them, "But whom say ye that I am?" Who do y'all say that I am? I mean, there's disciples, they've been with him and traveling around with him. And Simon Peter answered and said, "Thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God." And I really like what Peter said there. I'm a Father, Son, and Holy Ghost guy. And I'm sure I told y'all, but I was raised in a Oneness Pentecostal church. I never did join there, but my mom and dad made me go there from probably 8, 9 years old until I was about 14, something like that. But you would never, ever hear these scriptures being read in a Oneness church. And there's a lot of Baptist churches now. A lot of their preachers are Oneness. And you're not going to be hearing them reading this verse either. Let me read it again. Verse 16. Simon Peter answered and said, "Thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God." And what does Jesus say? And Jesus answered and said unto him, "Blessed art thou, Simon Barjona, for flesh and blood hath not revealed it unto thee, but my Father which is in heaven." So Jesus says, blessed are you. You know, if Jesus was the Father, as a lot of Oneness preachers want to say, then Jesus right there could have corrected Simon Peter and said, "No, Simon Peter, I'm not the Christ, the Son of the living God. I am the Father God. I'm the Father God." But no, Jesus didn't correct Simon Peter. Actually, he says, "You're blessed. Blessed are you, Simon Barjona, for flesh and blood hath not revealed it unto you." That means it wasn't no people told him that. He said, but Jesus says, "My Father, which is in heaven." He's the one who revealed it to you, Peter. And I say unto thee, thou art Peter, and upon this rock I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. And I will give unto thee the keys of the kingdom of heaven, and whatsoever thou bind on earth shall be bound. Turn this over. In heaven, and whatsoever thou loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven. Then charged he his disciples that they should not tell man that he was Jesus the Christ. So we'll leave it right there, but Jesus tells his disciples, he said, don't be telling nobody that I'm the Christ, the Son of God. Keep it to yourself. Alrighty, well, pray for me and Violet. We'll continue to mend and get better. I think we're going to skip church tomorrow. We don't want to go in there and be passing this bug around. I know my brother Tony over here, he says he's got COVID. So I don't know if me and Violet got COVID or what. I know we got a bug and God's delivering us from it, and I'm feeling a whole lot better. It's all good. Well, God bless y'all. I hope y'all have a good day today and a good Sabbath tomorrow. Bye-bye.